In this tutorial, we'll be going over the slider module. The slider module actually comes in two different formats, in the form of two different modules, either the standard slider module or the full width module. The full width slider module can only be placed within full width sections. As seen here, a full width slider will extend the full width of the page, while a standard slider will be fixed within the column you place it in. Let's go over how to add a slider to your page. So here I have a very standard page, some text and a sidebar, and I'd like to add a slider at the top here in a full width fashion. In this case, we'll need to add a new full width section in order to add our full width slider module. So I'm going to click the Add Full Width Section button and then click the Insert Modules button. I'm going to choose the full width slider. You have some initial options here. You can choose whether or not you'd like to display slider arrows. You can choose whether or not to display the little circle buttons at the bottom that allow you to click through each slide. You can also enable or disable parallax effect, which controls, which will fix your background images in place as you scroll, which creates a kind of cool effect. And you can adjust your admin label. So to add a new slide to your slider, click the Add New Slide button. You can input a heading text for the slide, or you can leave it blank if you don't want a heading. You can also add a button text or leave that blank if you don't want to add a button. If you do add a button, you can control where that button goes to by inputting your button URL. And then you can choose the background. You can either do a background image, a background color, or a background video. If you enable both a background color and a background image, then the background image is going to sit on top of that color. For this first slide, I'm going to just do a normal background color. I'm just going to give it a nice green blue. Okay. I'm going to leave the background image blank. Slide image, if you'd like to include a slide image, this will appear to the left of your text. And in this case, I'm not going to include a slide image, it's going to be a plain old text slide. You can also choose your text color, so since I'm using kind of a dark background, I want to keep my text light. I'm not doing a video background, so I can leave these blank. And then you can choose your text content. So this is a slide in the slider module of the Divi theme. Does not have any image. Just text. Okay, got some content for our slide. And I'm gonna click save. And you can see that the new slide has been added here. Let's save that and see what we have so far. I'm gonna preview the changes. So you can see the slider has been added here. Just text on a green background. There's only one slide, so I can't actually slide anywhere. Let's add some more. I'm also going to drag this to the top of the page since we don't really want it sitting at the bottom. So you can just drag and drop that full width row or section to the top. I'm going to click the settings link to get back into our full width slider settings, and I'm going to add a new slide. Heading 2, button text. Add a URL. This time I'm going to do a background image. So you can click the Upload Image button and choose an image for your background. I'm just going to use this stone background. I'm going to click Set as Background to choose it. You can see you get a nice little preview here. I'm also going to select a slide image, which will be displayed to the left of my text. So I'm going to click the Upload Image button and choose these stones here. I'm going to keep my text color light as before. And add in some random content and click Save. And let's see what that looks like. Click Preview Changes. Second slide has an image, fades in, text, image background. Looks good. Let's add one more slide This time, we can use a video background. So I'm going to add a new slide. Video slide, button text. I'm going to leave the background image blank. We don't need a background image. We're going to do a background video instead. I'm also not going to use a slide image in this slide. And text color, keep it light. So for video backgrounds, you're going to want to upload your video in two formats to provide optimum compatibility for all browsers. We're going to use MP4 and WebM. If you need more information about these formats, look below the video. We have some written documentation about that. In this case, I already have my videos ready, so I'm going to click Upload Video for my MP4 video. I'm going to choose my ink.mp4. And then I'm also going to choose my WebM version of the same video. Now you also want to make sure that you input the correct video width and height. So you need to know how tall in pixels and how wide in pixels your video is. Otherwise, the theme won't know how to resize it correctly. So this video is 1400 pixels wide and 600 pixels tall. And input some content, save, and let's see what we have. First slide, plain text on a green background. Second slide, background image with an image to the left of the text. And third slide, we have a really cool full width video background and some text. So that's the basic settings for a slider. Now these same settings apply for the normal slider as well. So if you go back, we did a full width slider. You can also add sliders inside columns as well. So if we wanted to add a slider here, you could do that. And all the settings are the same. Add a new slide. And in that case, the slide will not be full width. It'll be fixed to the column width. And yeah, that's a basic overview of the slider module.